For this afternoon's contest between the visitors on the scoreboard, Cheyney University, and your Central Penn College Lady Knights. Prior to this afternoon's ballgame, we would like to take time to recognize our senior Lady Knights. Today, we'd like to recognize our lone senior, number 11, Sydney Buck. Sydney is accompanied by her mother, Alicia Buck, her father, Jeff Buck, Grandma Sheila, and her brother, David. During her time at Central Penn College, Sydney was a member of the women's soccer and basketball teams and a member of the Gamma Beta Phi National Honor Society and the Legal Studies Society. Her athletic accomplishments include receiving the Most Valuable Teammate Award and the Nightly News Athlete of the Year in 2022. Bub is also a member of the 2023 ESAC Champions Women's Basketball Team and helped lead the program to their first ever USCAA National Championship Tournament appearance. Her favorite memory at Central Penn College was going into triple overtime at the USCAA National Basketball Tournament. After graduation, Sydney Bub hopes to obtain her Juris Doctorate degree and become a criminal defense attorney. Her final message to her teammates and the Central Penn College fans is, thank you for taking this ride with me for the past 3 years. I'm grateful for all the memories I made and wouldn't trade any of it for the world. To my team, I can't wait to watch you all succeed in your life. Keep working hard, and I wish you all nothing but the best. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for number 11, Sydney Ma.
Tonight's officials are Hillary Bauer, Mike Nagy, and Dave Udell.
Welcome here.
The USCAA and Central Penn College.
We are here at East Pennsboro High School. You're not going to get to hear me on the last day of the season because we got in the Nightly News Hall of Famers, Tyler Coleman and Brian Christiana. So they'll be with you here in just a moment.
Comments or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. And now for the starting lineups. First, for the visitors, Cheyney University, coached by Alicia Mosley. At guard, number 2, Sienna Robert. At guard, number 4, Tania Finney. At small forward, number 11, Natasha Braxton. At power forward, number 15, Jaden Patrick. And in the middle, number 22, Alicia Jones. The head coach for Cheyney is Alicia Mosley. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Central Penn College Lady Knights, coached by Stasia King. Stasia King. At point guard, number 4, Black Screen. At guard, number 5, Cayla Thomas. At small forward, wearing number 11, Sydney Bob. At power forward, wearing number 21, Brandy Swinton. And in the middle, wearing number 23,
a moment. I'm going to be producing the show today, but of course, Nightly News Hall of Famers Brian Christiana and Tyler Coleman will give you the action here from East Penn High School. Of course, if you're in the area, stop on down. Men's Senior Night will be later. So I'm going to turn it over to the guys. I got the easy job today. They're going to be the ones carrying you through this with the highest of intensity, even if you were up at 5 o'clock this morning.
It was the Elimination Chamber, Paul. You know what? It was a great day. And you know what? They gave me 3 seconds to run across that court, so you gotta give me some time to catch up, and I'm just, you know what, it's a great day, right, Tyler? You have a nice beanie on, I really like it.
Well, thanks, I like your Notre Dame sweatshirt there.
That's right.
It's always great to be here with you, Brian.
Dun, 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 dun. I'm trying to find people to go with me to go see Notre Dame in, New Jersey. Paul, are you gonna go with me? Paul said no to Notre Dame. Tyler, I mean, you're a married man now.
Depends on what it is, Brian.
All right, sounds good. Here we go. And it starts off with... All right, we have the ball to start it off here. 9:55 remaining in the first quarter. 0-0 is the score. Here come the Knights. Bub has the ball. Gets it to Green up top. Green inside the Bub. And it's stolen by Cheyney. Here comes down to, it's going to be out of bounds, and it will go back to Central Penn College.
A little bit of a sloppy start here to the game, Brian. A couple turnovers. Lady Knights have been struggling a little bit, losing 5 out of their last 6 games, so we're hoping here on Senior Day they can get things turned around.
Oh, tough pass there by Yoder. It's going to go out of bounds, but it will stay with Cheyney. Tyler, how was the travels here today?
Not too bad. A little bit chillier out today
it
than it's been,
chilly.
But how about you? You're the one that had a bit of a drive.
Oh, man. When you come down to Harrisburg around 6 o'clock in the morning, it's not easy. But it's a great day for Central Penn College basketball. Yoder has the ball, gets it up top there to number 5. That's Cayla Thomas. Try and get the ball inside. There's a screen there. Green. On the hands of Bob. Oh, in the corner. They get into, it's going to go out of bounds, but it will stay with the Knights. They're going to inbound the ball from underneath. get it up top. There you go. Good play. Oh, and it's blocked. Green gets the ball. Tough play there.
There we go.
Yeah. Looks like there might have been a little bit of travel there.
A little bit. It's close enough, but if you're the Lady Knights, they'll take it.
Hey, 2-0 the Knights lead. Shot clock? Looks like we're having some shot clock problems.
Now, I will say, that's been a pretty consistent issue, at least in the games I've called this year.
You know what? I think it's been every game. But it's all right. It's okay. And there we go. 8:57 remaining. 2-0. Knights lead. Can get good screen there. The mid-range jumper is off. And it's rebounded there by number 15. Turned out of bounds.
I think the Lady Knights have the height advantage here, so you can't be giving up too many offensive boards like that. Luckily, Cheney turned it over. But
8:45 remaining in the first quarter. 2-0 is the score. Green gets it in. Back to Green.
Got a little bit of a full-court press here early on.
Yep, and a travel's called, so an early turnover. 8:39 remaining in the first, and it's 2-0 Central Penn College.
You're Central Penn, though, you can't really afford the early turnover, so you got to get it straightened out here.
Ball in. Ooh, ball's inside. Oh, but a turnover stolen by Sydney Bubb. Here she goes down the court. Sydney Bubb goes. Throws in. Oh, but a late foul is called, and two shots will be taken at the line for Sydney Bubb.
Yeah, definitely liked her aggressiveness there. I thought she was going to have the easy layup, but either way, you'll definitely take the two free throws.
So as you heard, today is senior day. We recognize senior Sydney Bubb and Tyler. You've seen a lot of her games throughout the years. Tell us her impact on the court.
I mean, it's been pretty impactful, Brian. I mean, she's one of the senior leaders, you know, maybe not always the highest scorer, or, you know, not everything she does is seen in the stat sheet, but she's been one of those senior leaders, and you really appreciate what she's brought to this team, and you're gonna miss her impact after this season.
3-0 Central Penn College leads. Coach King brings all four starters back, so they'll get ready for defense, and she makes the second. Good start for the Knights, up 4-0 on Cheyney University. 8:22 remaining. Cheyney brings the ball down. They throw it up off the bank. Good shot there. That's by number 11, Natasha Braxton, and she cuts the lead down to two. Central Penn College, the tough part for them today, Tyler, is they're only going to have six players suited up.
Yeah, Paul and I were talking about that off camera. That's definitely going to be a tough hurdle to overcome.
Turnover by Yoder. It's going to be Cheyney ball. 4-2 with 8:03 remaining in the first, so our fans know. Four 10-minute quarters in women's basketball. Five fouls results in the bonus. They get the ball inside. Jumper. Shot is off and rebounded by Sydney Bump. She brings the ball down. Now in the hands of number 5, Cayla Thomas.
Another turnover's
right.
Got it.
Oh, and good pass there. Cheyney for two. Shot is off and rebounded by Flash Green. Oh, and it's stolen by Cheyney. And they tie the ball game. Good play there. That's by number 2, Johnson.
Definitely got to clean these turnovers up a little bit.
So Central Penn College will take a timeout. It's 4-4 with 7:25 remaining. We'll be right back.
The Knights baseball schedule has been released. Save the date for doubleheaders at FMB Field to kick off the season. On March 19th, the Knights will host Penn State Hazleton. Then on March 26th, the Knights host arch rival Bucks County Community College, both with 1 p.m. starts. You can keep up with Knights baseball all season at www.centralpennknights.com.
.25 remaining in the first tied ball game between Central Penn College and Cheyney University. Bub has the ball up top. They get past the full court press. Bub stuck on the wing. Oh, this is actually be stolen by Cheyney. Oh, tough play, but a foul on Flash Green. I don't know if that was, looked like a little bit of an anger foul there.
A little bit. Frustration from all these turnovers.
4-4 is the score with 7-11 remaining in the first quarter. And we're going to see go to the line, Natasha Braxton. She's shooting 67% from the line. The first. Oh, in and out. No subs at the table. 7-11. 4-4 is the score. Braxton, second shot. Ooh, in and out again. Rebounded by Central Penn College. And they're going to bring the ball down with 7:05 remaining in the first. Thomas has it. Thomas goes. Good defense being shown by Cheyney. They get the ball inside, but it's another turnover, Tyler.
These live ball turnovers are killing them right now.
Shot is blocked. Rebounded by the Knights. And here they go. 6:46 remaining in the first. Thomas. Shot is up and good.
Got to try to get that momentum shifted here a little bit.
6:40 remaining in the first. 6-4 is the score. Cheyney brings the ball down. Central Penn College, it looks like a 1-2-2 zone. And we're going to see a foul called on Central. That's on Flash Green. That's two fouls. And that is her second personal.
And that goes back to your point, only having six players. If you have somebody get into foul trouble, it's going to be tough coaching decisions to make.
Get the ball in the hands of number 11, Braxton. Now over to number 2. Good defense being shown here by Central Penn College. Oh, she's going to lose the ball, and it will go to the Knights.
Nice defense. Nice way to slide her feet and force the turnover.
6:16 remaining in the first quarter. We're going to see number 2, Mary Nyagakwa, come in the game, replacing number 4, Flash Green. Get a bin. Thomas has it. Thomas. Nyagakwa now has the ball. She brings it up. Gets it over to Yoder. Jumper. Good shot. Yoder for 2 with the assist from Nyagakwa. Yeah,
nice job to find the open shooter.
4-point lead now for Central Penn College. Oh, let's see. An offensive foul is called. Good play there defensively by the Knights. Number 23, Allison Yoder, stepped in front, drew the foul, and it will go to Central Penn College. Press still being shown here.
Well, if you're Cheyney, you're definitely not going to take the press off, especially since they've been forcing so many turnovers with it.
Thomas has the ball up top. 5:46 remaining in the first. 8-4 is the score. Bob has it. 3-point shot. Way off. Rebounded by number 3. That's Janaya Lilly. They try to get up. It's going to go out of bounds, and it will go to Central Penn College. So again, Central Penn College with turnovers, but Cheyney's in the same situation.
It's been a very sloppy first 5 minutes of the game here, Brian. But still plenty of opportunity to clean it up here and try to take advantage of Cheyney's mistakes.
5:35 remaining in the first. 8-4 is the score. Thomas has it. They get up to Nyagakwa. She goes, spins, gets it back to Thomas. Thomas dribbles to Yoder. Yoder keeps her dribble. Goes, trying to get it to Bub. They get it instead to Thomas. Back inside to Yoder. Yoder. Good play there by Yoder for 2. 10-4 the Knights lead, and we are halfway through the first quarter. Cheyney has the ball in the corner. That's number 1, Washington. Now in the hands of Braxton, who goes down, throws it up. Ooh, and a blocking foul's going to be called. Who they call the foul on it. Did you see by any chance who the referee?
I looked like a 2 he was holding up.
So maybe Allison Yoder on the inside. And first shot is off. Sub, more subs will come into the game. I thought they'd let the subs in, but interesting.
There you go.
Subs come into the game. 4:51 remaining in the first. 10-5 is the score. So far, offense has been clicking for the Knights, Tyler.
It has been here, especially the last few possessions. You know, it's funny, if they can figure out how to break this press and not turn the ball over, they've been scoring.
Turn the ball out of bounds and go to Cheyney. Tough call there. Surprise, no.
It's definitely a blocking foul.
.447 remaining in the first. 10-5 is the score. Cheyney dribbles. Oh, good pass inside, but a good block by Yoder.
Nice block.
Here come the Knights. Thomas crosses over. Again, Cheyney playing tough defense. Yoder has it up top. Yoder inside. And a travel is called. Another turnover, Tyler.
And I give Cheyney credit. They brought the double team and forced the turnover. But yeah, this is not looking good early on for the Knights.
Sydney Green comes back into the game. Cheyney's going to bring the ball down. Shot from the corner is off.
Sorry, bring the ball down.
Thomas for three. Shot is off. Rebounded by Green. And it's in the hands now of number 10 for Cheyney. They're bringing the ball down. 3:53 remaining in the first. They hand it off to number 4. That's Denia Allen. Back to Allen on the left side. Get the ball inside. Got to try to get something going for Cheyney. Mid-range jumper from the foul line.
Ooh, oh, got
falls.
The bounce. Central Penn's not been playing terrible defense. I mean, they're forcing a lot of outside shots for Cheyney.
Sydney Green has the ball. Gets it to Niagara. Back up top to Thomas. Thomas dribbles right. Crosses it over. Gets a screen from Yoder. Get it inside to Yoder. Yoder throws it up, and it's good! Allison Yoder playing lights out basketball so far.
Yeah, that was tough because they were bringing the double team on her, but she was able to get the turnaround shot up pretty quick.
3:02 remaining. 12-7 is the score. Got the ball in the corner. Oh, there you go. Good pass. Shot is up. It's off and rebounded by Yoder. Tough play here by both teams so far. Thomas throws it up. It gets fouled. And she'll go to the line to shoot two.
They'll take those two free throws. Looked like she took a tough ball, though.
Shot at the line.
Here we go.
First shot is good.
Now, Ryan, I'd like to get your opinion on this. If you see the Knights bring three players down the other end.
I love it. I'm
not
it.
Even trying to get the rebound.
I think it's a good idea.
Good way to set up the defense.
I do. Actually do.
Shot is up, and it's, almost coming out. Rebounded by Cheyney. They kick the ball out. 14-7, 2:22 remaining. Oh, good play there, good passing by Cheyney. It's up, and it's good. That's by number 2, Johnson.
If you're Central Penn, though, you want to keep forcing those outside shots for Cheyney because they've far and in between been falling. They've been missing a lot more, so you'll take that.
Green gets a rebound. Throws it up, and it's good by Sydney Green. side. Throws it up off the bank. Good play there. That's by number 11, Braxton, for two. I don't know what happened there. They looked like a little confused. <laughs> 16-11 is the score. 1:43 remaining in the first.
I definitely wanted to give you some credit, Brian. I think you did a very nice job on the PA announcing.
I appreciate that. That is ultimately always my favorite. Yoder goes in the lane. Looks like there might have been a little contact there, Tyler.
Yeah, I thought there was a foul. But there you go. Looks like they got a turnover back on the other end.
I don't know about that one either. That didn't really look like.
If you're the knight, you'll take it.
16-11, 1:23 remaining. They kick it out. Oh, and there's going to be a foul called on Cheyney underneath. One more foul, and it will result in foul shots, Tyler.
You'll be happy to take that if you get it.
Central Penn will call a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well here from East Pennsboro High School.
Central Penn students are invited to a virtual career fair through an Inspire of Junior Achievements to explore careers and organizations. JA Inspire will be available to students from March 1st until June 30th. That's right, a career fair available for over 3 months. Starting March 1st, you can register an account at the jafcpa.bsfairs.com. Last year, the exhibit hall featured booths for over 60 employers. Each booth includes a description of the company, videos, as well as job and internship openings. Other tools included in the career fair are webinars within the auditorium and career readiness activities within the activity lab. If you have questions about the career fair, contact career services at centralpenn.edu.
You know all about career services, Tyler.
Yes, I did. I had the pleasure of working 3 semesters with Steve there.
Shot from the corner is off and rebounded by Braxton. Cheyney gets the ball up. Number 4, Allen, and it's stolen by the Knights. Here they go, Sydney Green. Back up top to Thomas.
Do the Knights would like to close out this quarter strong here with 1 minute left?
Green shot is off. Rebounded by 4, Allen. And here comes Cheyney. They get the ball up. Number 15 has the ball. They get it, grabs it, but oh, late blocking foul is going to be called.
That was a tough one. It looked like she just turned the ball over.
16-11, 45 seconds remaining. Good crossover, step back jumper is way off. 16-11 is the score, 37.6 remaining in the first quarter. Tyler, thoughts on the first quarter so far?
It's been a little sloppy with a lot of turnovers, but so far the Knights have towards the end of the quarter here, been playing a little better. So if they can try to drain as much of this clock as they can to finish the quarter, try to score another basket, I think they'll be in good position.
Turnover by Thomas. Cheyney takes the ball. Good skip pass there, but a good defense by Allison Yoder. That's going to actually go back to Central Penn College. 20 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play.
And now at this point, they can just run the clock down and take the last
shot. Final possession.
Yep. Try to set up your best play here.
16-11, 15 seconds remaining. Thomas has the ball. Hands there. Now it's up to Sydney Green. Sydney Green. Good defense by Cheyney. Thomas has it, and it's stolen. 1 second, half court, good shot there by Braxton. And that will end the first quarter play at 16-11 in favor of Central Penn College over Cheyney, and we'll be right back. We're back here at East Pennsboro High School, 16-11 in favor of Central Penn College. Good start here for both teams. For Cheyney, Natasha Bratson, 5 points. Deanna Robert, 4. And number one, Miranda Carey, has 2 points. And now for the Knights, we're looking at...
I think Allison Yoder's got it there.
Allison Yoder, 6. Sydney Green, 4. Cayla Thomas has 4. Sydney Bubb has 2. Shot is off. Rebounded by Sydney Bubb. And the Knights have the ball. Sydney Green gets it to Thomas. She's going to bring the ball down. It's 16-11, still 9:25 remaining in the second. Bubb dribbles, gets it to Green. They get it inside to Bubb. Good play. And it falls. 18-11, 9:12 remaining in the first half, Tyler.
Second basket for the senior Knights player here.
Cheyney brings the ball down. Oh, good pass there to Braxton. And he gets another pass, but tipped by Bubb. They're going to give that to Central Penn College. Interesting. I thought that was going to be staying with Cheyney.
Well, not going to complain. He'll take the ball if he can get it.
Starting to sound like you're hired by Central Penn College, Tyler. Oh, man, look at him. He's laughing, ladies and gentlemen. You can't see him. But stolen by Braxton. She's going down the court. She throws it a foul in the basket. Great play there by Braxton. That's going to be a foul on Sydney Bubb.
Wow. A nice play on behalf of Cheyney.
Wow, look at you. That's great.
Don't want to sound too biased, Brian.
Starting to sound like Paul Miller.
Where do you think I learned it from?
Shot is up by Brad. Oh, in and out. Rebounded by Sydney Green. And here come the Knights. 8:46 remaining. 18-13 is the score. 8:40 remaining. They get up top to Green. Green. They're getting inside to try and get it to Yoder, and Dockwell has the ball. Kicks it out to Bubb, but a travel is called. Another turnover, Tyler.
Yeah, this Knight's got to clean this up.
Six players in uniform today for the Knights.
You take away about half of these turnovers, just imagine how big this score could be.
18-13 is the score, 8:28 remaining in the first half. Out to Bratson. Bratson's been the offensive catalyst for Cheyney. Oh, it's in a lot of bounds, and it will stay with Cheyney. Again, it doesn't seem like a lot of offense is happening for Cheyney, but they're doing very well at staying in this game.
Well, they're staying in this game by forcing the nice turnovers.
Bratson almost loses the ball. They kick it out. Gets a screen. She goes up, and she draws a foul. Great play there. So we're going to see.
Brian, you've been calling a lot of basketball this season.
Yeah, it's been very busy.
How's everything else going for you?
Well, Mount Carmel, both men's and women, lost the last two nights, so we are done. And then this is my final Central Penn game for the year for basketball. So, for my team, because I've been helping coach, has a big game today, so I'm hoping they can pull off a victory.
Now be able to make it?
I know, it's at 1 o'clock. They're playing in Danville, PA. A big game for them today, stolen by Braxton. She goes down the court. 18-13 is the score. 3-point shot is up, and it's off. Rebounded by Sydney Bubb. Thomas has the ball. 7:25 remaining in the first half.
I got to set something up here. I feel like it's been a while since we've seen a nice basket.
Thomas goes, oh, Yoder! Oh, they're going to call a foul. Braps is not very happy about the call. That's going to be on Miss Braxton. Yoder will go to the line to shoot two. Swinton comes back in.
Yeah, it's interesting to see how the Knights are going to use their one sub and sort of rotate players in and out.
7:17 remaining in the second quarter. Yoder at the line. Misses the first of two. Second shot is good. 19-13, 7:15 remaining in the first half. Braxton bringing it down. Oh, good save there. Finney will get fouled, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. Tania Finney, number four for Cheyney. Get on the information that they're finding on Cheyney's website. The rosters are a little incorrect here.
She misses the first free throw, so that's a good sign.
So we have number 15 and Jaden Patrick on the court. Number four, Tania Finney. Miss Braxton, number 11. Number 10 is Maya Bynum. And then number one, Miranda Carey. 19-14 is the score, 7 minutes remaining. Pump fake there by Ndakwa. Oh, good crossover! Nice. To Yoder. Yoder has to dribble. They gotta find a way to get the ball moving. Bub has it, but guarded by
5 seconds left.
Yep.
There we go.
By Cayla Thomas.
That was a shot clock that expired. What a shot.
And it's stolen by Cayla Thomas. There she goes down the court, throws it up, and it's off. Rebounded, hit it out of bounds. Oh, it's going to stay with Central Penn. Another one, Tyler. I don't know.
I don't know either, but would have liked to see Cayla pass that ball. They had a 3-on-1 advantage.
22-14, 6:22 remaining.
Yeah, hopefully the Knights can try to get some more points here with the ball under their own basket.
22-14, 6:22 remaining in the second quarter. They get it to Bub. Oh, they try to get... And she draws and foul. That looks like it's going to be on number 10, Maya Bynum. Central Penn College only has 6 players today, Tyler.
Yeah, if Cayla would be out of the game with an injury, that would be tough to be running with 5 players the rest of the game.
5:52 remaining in the first half, 22-14 is the score. Clinton has the ball. They get it inside. And Ndakwa throws it up, and it's off. Rebounded by Yoder, who throws it up, and it's off. Rebounded by number one, Carey. And here comes Cheyney. Now in the hands of Finney. Finney up top now to number 3. That's Kayla Johnson, or Kyla Johnson. Johnson has it on the left wing. Central Penn College showing 2-3 defense here, fans. Number 1, Carey has the ball. They get it inside. Shot is up, and it's good by number 10, Maya Bynum. Cheyney's figuring out ways to get within that press. Stolen by Cheyney. And an easy 2 for them.
You can't do that. You can't turn the ball over under your own basket there.
Central Penn brings the ball up. Yoder has it. Yoder puts the ball on the floor, crosses over, and it's stolen by Cheyney. I'm Coach King. Maybe a timeout needs to be taken. Cheyney has the ball.
Yeah, got to try to slow this momentum down for Cheyney.
Shot is up. It's off. Rebounded by Yoder. Coach King telling her to slow it down, but Yoder keeps going down the court, Tyler.
Yeah, you definitely need a basket here. Really got to help swing that momentum back to your side.
22-18 is the score. Yoder has the ball. Inside to Green. It is off. And it's rebounded by number 4. That is Tania Finney. Good defense being shown by Central Penn College. It's going to be a jump ball that will go to Central Penn College.
Yeah. Cayla Thomas checking back into the game, so it's nice to see that she's doing all right.
22-18, 4:16 remaining in the first half. Thomas has the ball. She dribbles. They get it inside, but it's stolen, but back in the hands of Yoder, who throws up there. Oh!
Wow.
I don't know about that one.
That looked like a block.
That's going to be on Jaden Patrick. I don't know. That's a tough call.
And Allison's got to take advantage of these two free throws.
22-18 is the score. 4:09 remaining in the first half of this USCAA women's contest. Big game here today for Central Penn College, Tyler. It's senior night.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was looking at the stat sheet earlier. It says they're 0-8 at home. So how about getting a first home win here on senior night?
Second shot is off. Oh, could have been an over the backbone Sydney Green there. And that would have been her third. Number two, Sienna Robert has the ball. They get it in. Shot is up by number 10, Maya Bynum for two, and it's down to 2 points. Oh, it's a bad pass by Green that almost gets stolen by Bynum. And Bynum's playing very good basketball.
Yeah, I agree with you right now, Brian. I think a timeout would be really helpful to try to get things together a little bit. But
Bub has the ball. Full court press being shown here. Thomas ends up with the ball, but I don't think it was meant to go to Thomas. She throws it up. It's off, and it's rebounded by Cheney. Skip pass. Good stolen by Sydney Bub. Oh, she got away with a travel, Tyler.
There we
good
go.
Coach, Coach King calls a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well here from East Pennsboro High School. It's 22-20 Central Penn College.
It's hard to study when you're hungry. The College Pantry can help. Central Penn College and your Student Government Association are committed to ensuring that all of our CPC Knights have access to food when they need it. Requests are kept anonymous and can be submitted online. Look for the link under the link section of Student Central or contact Lindsay Garber, Director of Housing and Residence Life at lindsaygarber@centralpenn.edu.
So Tyler, 22-20 is the score here at East Pennsboro High School. What's your thoughts so far in this ball game?
Well, a lot of turnovers, some missed free throws that the Knights need to start taking advantage of. And I like Central Penn's defense. They're forcing a lot of outside shots for Cheney. Just got to figure out how to get the offense going a little bit more.
22-20 is the score, 3:32 remaining in the second quarter. Green has the ball. She dribbles, picks up her dribble. Now to Swinton. Dribbles in the corner, now into Yoder. Yoder, he throws it up, oh, off the rim, and it's off, and it's rebounded there by Cheney. Bynum has the ball. Bynum kicks it out, and it's stolen by Thomas. She dribbles. Oh, tough pass to Green. It's going to go out of bounds, and it will go to Cheney. So again, Tyler, it's a turnover.
This has been a turnover fest today, Brian. I mean, it's not just one team. It's them both all game long.
The hands of number one for three. It's off. Bynum. Good save by Bynum. Johnson goes. Throws it off. It is off and rebounded by Bub. Sydney Bub has the ball. Up defense by Johnson. Coach King trying to see if they'll call a foul, and they don't. Thomas now has it up top. He's guarded by number two, Sienna Robert. Swinton has it on the left corner. Back to Green, inside to Yoder, and it's stolen by Cheney. But then ends up back in the hands of CP, and then it's stolen again by Miranda Carey. Carey, jumper, shot is off, rebounded by number two, that is Sienna Robert.
The Knights can't give up the offensive rebounds either. Gotta leave Cheney at 1-1.
Shot is up. Bynum for three. It's off and rebounded by Swinton. Cayla Thomas has it. 1:55 remaining in the first half, Tyler.
Yeah, Brian, they got to close these last couple minutes out strong.
Central Penn College has not scored a basket in a few minutes here, so you got to find ways to get some points on the board. It's going to be on the floor foul, but it will result in two shots. It's going to be on number three. That is Cayla Johnson. That's her second.
It's been a struggle offensively here trying to score baskets. You got to take advantage of your free throws.
Thomas at the line will shoot two. First shot is good. Second shot is good. 24-20 is the score. 1:45 remaining in the first half. Braxton brings the ball down. She's guarded by Green. They kick it out. And a travel is called. Another turnover, Tyler.
Another turnover, but you got to try to take advantage of it here. 97 seconds left in the first half.
Cheyney has 12 turnovers.
More than that, yeah. Say about 15.
19.
31 combined turnovers.
31 combined turnovers in the first half alone. Let's be honest, this game would probably be close to being over. We'd be closer to halftime.
If Central Penn didn't have 19 turnovers, yeah, they could easily have a double-digit lead.
24-20 is the score, 1:17 remaining. Sydney Green has the ball underneath. Get it in the Tom. Back inside to Green. Oh, tough play. 2 seconds. And the travel is called. Turnover. They'll go to Cheyney with 1:08 remaining in the first half. Substitution will come in. Met Mary Nagakwa again for Sydney Green, who has 2 fouls tied up.
You know what, Brian? To her credit, she picked up 2 early fouls in the first quarter and has been playing well since. So good job to not pick up that third foul.
So it's either, looks like an extended 3-2. So it could either be a 1-2-2, 3-2. And the ball up top. Oh, tough play there. Roberts still has the ball. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Johnson passes it. Oh, and we're going to see a jump ball that could stay with Cheyney.
Looked like there was only about 2 or 3 seconds left on the shot clock. So 3 seconds, you don't want to commit a foul here.
3 seconds left on the shot clock. Hey, that's a turnover. Owned by Cayla Thomas. Oh.
Looks like backcourt, Tyler. At this point, I think you need to just slow it down. Get the best shot.
Bob for three. Shot it off. Rebounded by number 11, that is Natasha Braxton. Man, it looks like Cheyney's going to call a timeout with 20 seconds remaining. We'll take a timeout as well here from East Pennsboro High School.
The Nightly News Media Club at Central Penn College is looking for new members. Members have the opportunity to get hands-on experience writing for our students' publications, the Nightly News, being a part of the Nightly News podcast, and being a part of our sports live stream broadcast. Email club advisor Professor Paul Miller at paulmiller@centralpenn.edu.
And again, for Cheyney, Braxton with 7, Bynum with 6, Robert with 4, Carey with 2, and then Finney has a point. So again, the scoring has been spread pretty evenly for Cheyney.
Yeah. It's a good team effort, though.
Then for the Knights, Cayla Thomas 9, Allison Yoder 7, Sydney Green 4, and then Sydney Bubb 4 as well.
Cheyney smartly calling a timeout with 20 seconds left. See what play they set up here before half.
24-20, 15 seconds remaining. Off, rebounded by Bob. We got a couple seconds left. Gotta throw it up. And they don't get a chance to get a shot up. So that's the end of the first half. It's 24-20 in favor of Central Penn College. I want to thank everybody for listening to the Nightly News halftime show here on the stream. Natasha Bratson, 7. Maya Bynum, 6. Tiana Robert, 4. Miranda Terry, 2. Tiana Finney, 1. And for Central Penn, Cayla Thomas, 9. Allison Yoder, 7. Sydney Green, 4. And then Sydney Bubb has 4. So we're going to take a 15-minute break. We'll be right back with second half action right here on our YouTube channel. All right, we're back. You know, the fastest 15 minutes of the day, Tyler. It's always a good time here at East Pennsboro High School. Time for the second half action between Cheyney University and Central Penn College. The Knights are leading 24-20. And again, let's see. Oh, Sydney Green will start off on the bench for the Knights.
Looking for the Knights to get off to a strong start here. Try to get an early basket on the first possession and try to move away from all those turnovers in the first half.
Thomas has the ball. Thomas, he goes inside, kicks it out to Yoder. Yoder, mid-range jumper is off. Rebounded, and Yoder ends up back with the ball, but it's a turnover. It ends up out of bounds, and it will stay with Central Penn College. 9:38 remaining in third, still 24-20. Tyler, I'm going to stress it again, turnovers.
I mean, combined over 30 for both teams. It was a very sloppy first half.
Aqua throws it up, and it's off, and it's rebounded by Cheyney. It's going to be out of bounds, so another turnover, Tyler.
I feel like that's word of the day, Brian.
Yep. Yeah. Turnovers.
You're the Knights here under your own basket. You got to figure out a way to score.
Get the ball. Oh, it goes back to Yoder.
Wow.
Yoder.
Wow, that was lucky.
So another turnover.
It was, pretty much another turnover, but Allison Yoder is able to get the ball back.
26-20 is the score. 9:20 remaining in the third. Shot is up. It's off. Rebounded by Braxton. She throws it up, and it's off. It's going to be, out of bounds. It's going to be wide ball. Central Penn College gets the ball back with 9:09 remaining in the third.
And it looks like Cheyney's bringing the full court press again early on. Cheyney was forcing a lot of Knights turnovers with this press, so Lady Knights got to figure out how to break it.
Thomas has the ball, got to get the ball up. Hurry up, and it's a turnover.
There it is.
Get there by number 15, Jaden Patrick. It's going to be 26-22. And another foul on Central Penn College. Sydney Green's going to come back into the game. Shot is up, and it is good. Jaden Patrick makes it. Oh my goodness. That's another turnover.
That was not a good pass. Like, if you're the Lady Knights, you got to come through the ball. You can't stand there and try to make a football pass.
22 turnovers.
The way it's going, they're going to have 40 by the end of the game.
Imagine a team having 40 turnovers and popping.
If they manage to win this game with all these turnovers, I'll be really surprised.
Won't be many contests, many opportunities left for the Central Penn College Lady Knights after today, Tyler. Braxton has it. She's the leading scorer for Cheyney tonight. Or this afternoon, I'm sorry. Robert gets it over. Braxton off. Rebounded by Yoder. Oh! Going to be a jump ball. And it will stay with Cheyney. It's not a wrestling match, Tyler.
We do have a pretty good crowd here for Senior Day, Brian. And some of the fans getting into it a little bit with the call.
Oh, they're getting into it, all right. Braxton has it. I don't know what Coach King is complaining about over there. Going to go out of bounds and another turnover, Tyler.
I mean, I'll say this, Brian. Central Penn's gotten a lot of calls in their favor today. So,
I agree.
You know, it's kind of up to the players here to take advantage of that.
The 1-2-2 defense being shown again, which does eventually lead to the 3-2. Thomas gets it up to Bub. Bub, layup. Ooh. You got lucky there, Tyler, because the steps. Too many steps. 28-23 is the score.
It's another one of those calls we were just talking about, but we'll take it.
Cheyney has the ball, number four. That is Tamia Finney has it. Shot is off and it's off, rebounded by Bub. She has to dribble, get something going here. And Sydney Bub needs to be very careful.
A lot of time carrying that ball.
Yes, a walk or a carry can be called. Yoder has it. They get inside the Swinton. Shot is up and good! 30-23 is the score with 7:30 remaining in the third quarter. Turnover.
Yeah, Cheney's definitely not playing much better turnover wise.
Ball in with the Knights in the corner. Sydney Green has it. Good screen by Yoder. Ooh, chance for a pick and roll. You got to take advantage of that, Tyler.
Yeah, that's something we haven't been seeing much at all in today's game.
3 second violation, so another turnover on Central Penn College, Tyler.
Just kind of shoot themselves in the foot at this point.
And at this point, when is it? You got it. Coach King needs to be.
I honestly
need to stress it to the player.
I don't know how she's not pulling her hair out at this point. I mean, this
I mean,
is.
Don't get me wrong, the player, but that's also on coaching. Braxton, shot. It's good.
King bringing the full court press.
And another turnover.
Just not understanding those passes.
3-point shot is up. It's off. Should have gone off. Oh, but it stays. 15. That is Jaden Patrick gets fouled and she'll shoot two.
I'm at this point, Tyler, though. This is a lot of fundamental stuff that the Penn College is lacking. Yeah, no, it definitely is.
This is stuff like
very sloppy.
You should be practicing in middle school, high school.
And my thing is, too, with the press, you know, you see that all the time. So this isn't something new. They should have. You know, play calls down and how to break.
Patrick makes the first of two. 6:32 remaining in the third quarter. The second free throw by Jaden Patrick, number 15, is good. 30-27 is the score. 6:32 remaining. And Coach King is going to call a timeout. And I would have taken it a few minutes earlier, Tyler, I'll be honest. We're going to take a timeout as well here from East Pennsboro High School, and we'll be right back.
The Central Penn College app was designed with students in mind. The app brings the school to your fingertips and enables you to connect with Central Penn community. Stay on top of your events, classes, and assignments with the built-in calendar function and get notified of important dates, deadlines, and security announcements. Make friends, ask questions, and access campus resources at any time. Search Central Penn College in the App Store.
.32 remaining. 30-27 is the score. Thomas has it. She gets it to Sydney Green. Full court press. Being shown. And ends up in the hands of Central Penn College. Cayla Thomas.
And that ball only bounced off of those five players. It's a tough call to see, especially.
And it's a turnover. Braxton misses. Oh, but they're right there for the rebound. Braxton's down. That's going to be an injury. Four. Ooh, that's not good. She is down. And we're going to take a timeout here from East Pennsboro High School. It's 30-29 Central Penn College. back here at East Pennsboro High School, 30-29 with 6:05 remaining in the third. The Craftson steps off the court. Looks like got under her own power, though, so hopefully we get to see her back in this contest soon. Thomas has it up to Yoder. Good play there to Green. He gets inside, but ends up back with Central Penn College, but it's rebounded back to Yoder, and it's a jump ball that's going to stay with the Knights. Stop the shot clock. Stop the shot clock. Oh, man. Bub has it in the corner. Bub inside to Yoder. Yoder throws it up. But a travel is called. So it's going to be another turnover, Tyler. I think we've heard that before. Tyler, I'm going to be honest. The man I coach with, Mr. Michael Fumbara, always stresses turnovers. And I'm going to be honest, every turnover is a suicide.
Yeah. I mean, you're costing yourself right now.
Shot is up. And it's off. Rebounded by Patrick for two.
Right there, the turnover. You give up your second chance points.
Yep.
Keep containing.
Turnover by Central Penn College. Ooh, and a travel there. And Johnson makes the two-point shot. It's a three-point lead. Thomas goes up. Good block there by Johnson. Oh, and Cayla Thomas is down. I don't know why she's giving problems to the officials.
Cayla Thomas is down in the first half as well.
Cayla Thomas comes back under her own power. Sydney Bubb's still down there talking to the official, and again, I didn't think there was anything crazy, Tyler, I'll be honest.
It just looked like a hard foul. I mean, yeah. She went up into two defenders.
It's 5:06 remaining. 33-30 is the score. 33-30 is the score. Shot is up and it's off. Stolen by Bub. Another turnover in the ball game. Bub's going down the court. She goes up. Oh. Oh, offensive foul. I'm a little confused. What are we calling there, Tyler? I mean, offensive foul is a little, I don't know about that.
I think the defender, like, jumped right into it.
Coach King is on the court. She needs to get off before they call a technical foul. Paul, I don't know if I agree with it, but
I'll tell you what, the crowd's getting into it.
Well, then they can become an official. That's where I'm at. Shot is up, and it's off. Rebounded there, but it's a turnover. That ends up back in the hands of Cheyney. Shot is up, and it's off. And it's rebounded by Sydney Green. But it's another turnover. Shot is up, and there's a foul call. Is the score, 4:23 remaining in the third.
Yeah, the biggest thing I can say is how much Central Penn's been turning the ball over. They're just lucky Cheney's not taking more advantage of it.
33-30 is the score, 4:23 remaining in the third. I just love when fans, I enjoy it.
Rebound!
What makes the game better.
35-30 is the score, 4:23 remaining in the third. Next, we will have our men's matchup against Cheyney, where we will celebrate Senior Day for the men as well. Sydney Green has the ball, 4:15 remaining in the third, 35-30 is the score.
Will you be doing the PA announcement?
I will, yeah.
There you go. Busy game for you.
Oh, Bob for three. Oh, shot is off. Oh, is that going to be a backcourt? Let's see. Oh, they did not call backcourt. I agree on that one. Cayla Thomas has to throw it up. Oh, she got fouled! Wow!
Foul shooting three. And there was only 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Man, if you're Cheney, you can't be doing that.
Three shots. 35-30 with 3:53 remaining in the third quarter. Technical foul. I think that's going to be on Coach King. Coach King gets a technical foul.
You see her walking to the end of the bench there. Definitely not happy about something.
Technical foul is called. Sounds, Tyler.
Anyway, it doesn't matter what team, what level. I mean, you're always going to wonder when there's calls that lopsided.
Thomas, this is a free throw. There's one more free throw, and then we'll shoot the technical free throws. And the shot is off. Net shot. It's good. It really has, Tyler. It really has. We're only at 3:53 in the third. I got that note.
Yeah.
I would have done that.
Think the Yankees are going to be good this year?
Yankees should be good this year. I mean, Juan Soto.
I keep hearing them linked to Blake Snell, too.
Oh, the first one is good there for Cheney. Second is off. Cheney will get the ball back. Nice to inbound the ball. Well, Cheney, I'm sorry. 3:46 remaining in the third. 36-31 is the score. Skip pass it over in the corner for three. Off. Offensive rebound by Cheney. They go inside, kick it out. That's Johnson. Yes, for two. Oh, almost another turnover, Tyler.
Bynum almost
with the steal. Thomas gets it to Green. Green to Yoder. Back to Thomas up top. And it's a turnover.
Cheney out on the fast break. Gets the open three.
Shot is off. Rebounded by Bynum. Johnson puts it up. And it's off. Rebounded by the late by Cheney. They get it inside. That's Patrick, and it's good for a 9-point Cheney lead.
You know, and amongst all these turnovers, and correct me if I'm wrong here, Brian, Central Penn only has 7 points this quarter. That's a problem when you're turning the ball over.
Yoder has it near half court. She dribbles it up. And it's a turnover, Tyler. No inside pump fake. Shot is up. It's good. Good layup there by Cheney. Now an 11-point lead.
Cheney's starting to pull away now.
Here come the Knights. Dockwell has it. Oh, almost backcourt there. And like you said, a lot of this is fundamental stuff that you should be going over in middle school.
These turnovers are sort of outrageous at this point.
Thomas dribbles, loses the ball, and it will stay with the Knights. Offensive foul, where are we calling? Yep, offensive foul. Another turnover.
That looks like they turned the ball over every possession they've had here, Brian.
Turnover with 2:05 remaining in the third quarter. 42-31 is the score. Cheney bringing the ball down. Cheney has it up top. Shot is up. Rebounded by Yoder. That's fouled by Bynum. Oh, technical foul. Who are we calling? That's going to be on Bynum.
Unsportsmanlike.
Unsportsmanlike technical foul called on number 10.
She looks confused. Bynum's going to take a seat after that call.
.149 remaining in the third. Thomas will go to the line to shoot a free throw. It's off. Got to make your free throw,
yeah.
Tyler.
This is another thing, too, that's hurting.
It's good. Offensive foul. Offensive foul on Yoder. That's another turnover, Tyler.
You can see the body language of the Central Mike player is not good right now, but you're bringing a lot of this on yourself. Like, you can turn this game around.
And Aqua playing tough defense there. I'll give her. That was really good defense. 3-point shot. And it's all way off. And Godwin throws it up. Yeah, Why?
Where is that going?
Turnover. It's going to go out of bounds, and it will stay with Cheney with 1:18 remaining. Number two, that's Sienna Roberts. She has the ball. Legal screen being called on Cheney, so that's a turnover for Cheney. .42-32, 1:13 remaining. See these turnovers. Oh boy.
Do you even want to?
Oh boy. 32 turnovers, Tyler. 32.
We just talked about a few minutes ago they're going to have at least 40.
They get it inside the green. Oh, and there's another one. There's 33. been tough, Tyler. It's been tough. But again, turnovers are so important.
Especially live ball turnovers.
42-32, 50 seconds remaining in the third. Cheyney has the ball. They have now in the hands of Miranda Carey. They kick it to Robert for three. Shot is good by Robert. Sydney Bubbs and inbound the ball. In the hands of Thomas. Back to Bubbs. Good breaking of the press there by Bubbs.
Cheyney's not going to break that press considering how many turnovers are
that was going to be called on Robert. Again, tough call, but it was the right call, I would say. The big thing you need out of the officiating, Tyler, I'm going to be serious about it, is you want consistency.
Yeah, I mean,
consistently
that's
good or
biggest,
consistently bad.
The biggest thing you can ask. It's like umpiring in baseball, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you might not always call the perfect strike, but at least it gives you an idea of what they're calling.
Green, pump fake, goes inside, mid-range jumper. Shot is off, rebounded by Bub, who throws it up, and it's good. Great play there by the senior, Sydney Bub, to cut the lead down to 11. 16 seconds remaining.
Got to play tough defense here and don't give up a foul.
Shot is up and it's off, rebounded by Thomas. And it's a turnover. That's a turnover. But there's 0.7 remaining on the clock.
I didn't think they were going to call that.
Oh, man. The manager for the team almost threw the ball and hit the girl. They get the ball in, and that's the end of the third quarter. 45-34 is the score at the end of three. We're going to go to the fourth quarter right after these messages. Fourth quarter action.
So final 10 minutes of the game here, Brian.
Yeah.
See if Central Penn can turn it around at all.
Good defense there by the Knights. Oh, off the feet. Oh, could have called a good ball. It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to go back to the Knights. Oh, that's interesting. The man just stood up and said, who lost the baby? And they found the baby. Huh. And about 3 years back. That was very, very interesting. Oh, another turnover. Cheyney has the ball. Robert, jumper, shot is off. And, oh, good rebound there by Cheyney.
I think Central Penn's even given up too many second chance opportunities.
That could have been a walk. Bratson has it. Gets the ball inside. And we're calling a travel. So another turnover for Cheyney.
Probably only about half of what Central Penn is at this point.
45-34 is the score. 9-11 remaining on the scoreboard. seen some technical fouls be called here today, Tyler.
I think this is the most I've seen in the game in a while.
Tyler, you all. Oh, Tyler, I thought that fell. Here comes Cheyney. Oh, turnover. And next, we'll see our men's contest. We're going to celebrate the seniors. Looking forward to seeing Mr. Rodney Ross. Oh, deep pass there. Let's see if he gets it. Oh, and a turnover.
Something like that. Like, the pass is just unwarranted.
.45-34, 8:40 remaining in the fourth quarter. Let's see what we're looking at here. Team comparison. 36 turnovers compared to 21. And there's number 22.
22 is an awful lot, but compared to 36.
I told you, the team that I help out with, every turnover is a suicide.
Yep, every time you turn the ball over, you're costing yourself up points.
Looking forward to seeing Mr. Rodney Ross, Riley Young, Jordan Strickland. There's going to be some good basketball out here in about, hopefully, in the next 25 minutes or so. Aqua has it. She dribbles. Good steal by Cheyney. Oh, good pass. Shot is up, but a foul is going to be called from behind, and that's going to be Sydney Bob.
And the Knights have gotten lucky. Nobody's gotten into too much foul trouble. So we talked at the top of the game with only six players.
And a sub. Sydney Bubba out. Shot is good by Robert. Second shot at the line.
Rebound.
He's good. Jump ball is called. It will go to Cheyney. So guess what that is, Tyler?
I'm not sure at this point.
Another turnover. And I'm sure there was a couple that were missed down on the floor. So I would say probably 30.
10 points alone in this half. The Pens really hurt themselves.
Green has the ball. 7:57 remaining in the fourth. 47-34 is the score. Green to Yoder. Yoder. Shot is up. It's off. Tough play there. I thought Yoder had that one going.
Hey, at least they got the shot off.
Technical foul.
Come on, coach.
And that foul is on Coach King.
Yep. Is that her second?
That's what I'm waiting to see, if that's her second. If they're conversing like that, it sounds like she's going to come.
You think if that's her second, she's gone.
We're going to take a break here from East Pennsboro High School. We'll be right back. All right, we're back here with the technical free throws here at Pennsboro High School. First is made by Cheney. And the second is off. So I thought that was Coach King's second technical. I must be wrong. .48-34 is the score. Still conversing here on the floor.
Now what are we trying to figure out?
We're trying to figure out dinner plans, you think?
They really slowed this game down here in the second half.
.48-34. We finally hit 7:40 remaining in the fourth. Cheney has the ball. Shot is up. Oh, and it's off. Rebounded by Thomas. He brings the ball down. Screen there from Yoder. Thomas throws it up, but there's a foul. Shots from Cayla Thomas.
So 7:23 left in the game. Central Penn just trying to figure out a way to hang in there.
First is good. Down on the court, Mr. Rodney Ross. Looking forward to seeing Mr. Ross. Second shot is, ooh, in and out. Rebounded. Rebounded by Cheney. 48-35. Shot is up by Braxton in the top. Rebounded by Thomas. Uh-oh. Wonder what the security guards. And Yoder. Gets a screen. It's an 11-point game. 6:40 remaining in the fourth. Shot is up. It's off. Rebounded. Sent it out of bounds, and it will go to Central Penn College. Sydney Green looks like she might have got hurt on the play. .48-37, 6:34 remaining, and it's in the hands of Cayla Thomas. Ooh, she got away with the travel there. Thomas goes down, throws it up off the bank, it's good! .48-39, 6:20 remaining in the fourth, single out of bounds. We will stay with Cheney.
Second time he's throwing things up, there's still enough time to try to make a comeback.
48-39, 6:15 remaining in the final quarter of play. Braxton has the ball. Cheney trying to get an offensive possession with some points on the board. It's off. Rebounded by Cheney. They go down the lane. Shot is up. And she's fouled.
Since Penn played tough defense up until the final second there on the shot clock.
First is off.
Rebound.
shot. Rebound. It's good. 10-point lead for Cheyney with 6:01 remaining. Oh, Yoder has it. Yoder picks up her dribble, throws it over, and it's a turnover.
Turnover.
Good pass there, Roberts, for two, and it's good.
Cheyney played that well. They got the turnover and then easy points. That's why they're pulling away in this game.
Guys up and it's off. Rebounded by Swinton. She throws it up and it's off. And it's rebounded.
Nice Cheyney. Knights had three opportunities there. Unfortunately, couldn't score.
51-39, 5:25 remaining in the fourth. Cratson has it. Robert now on the left wing. They get the ball inside. Throws it up. And it falls. It's good for Cheyney. From all the way in the corner. That's crazy, Tyler. You had an official all the way in the corner. All the way where but the P is in Panthers making a call all the way near half court.
I think you wonder why players and coaches get frustrated.
That's a very
suspicious when you talk about consistency.
Fifty-3:39, 4:57, and Bub has the ball inside, it's gonna go out of bounds, and it's a turnover. That will go to Cheyney. Fifty-3:39, 4:45 remaining in the fourth. Get the ball in. Robert has it, guarded by Bub. Let's see what happens. Oh, they're going to call a foul there on the floor. It's going to be on Cayla Thomas. Fifty-3:39, 4:36 remaining in the fourth.
The Knights are just trying to get something going offensively here to try to finish out this game on the right note.
Shot is up, off the bank, it's off. Rebounded by Bub. Bub needs to get the ball up front. Oh, look behind her. Good crossover. Here comes Sydney Bub. Gives it to Ngakwa. Ngakwa gets it to Bub. Bub for three. Shot is off. Rebound by Yoder, she's blocked. It's gonna be a foul on Robert.
A couple free throws for Yoder coming up here. The Knights been struggling with their free throws a little bit in this game as well, so gotta take advantage of these two here. First one's missed.
Fifty-3, 39, 4:10 remaining in the final quarter of play. Yoder's second free throw is off.
No good as well.
Man, Yoder's usually automatic from the line, Tyler.
I think it's been that kind of game for the entire team.
4 minutes remaining, 53-39. Robert for three. Dagger. Dagger. 56-39, 3:45 remaining in the fourth. Sydney Green dribbles. Oh, gets away with it. Fadeaway jumper, and good.
Nice move.
Great shot there by Sydney Green. 56-41, 3:30 remaining in the fourth. Good defense here by Central Penn College. Oh, what a good crossover.
Yes.
Oh, and it's off rebounded by Bub. Sydney Bub bringing the ball down. Bub gets it to Thomas. Oh, and a blocking foul. Cayla Thomas having a rough day.
She's been taking a few hard hits.
She has been playing lights out basketball. She's a hard, good player. clock is still going. 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. There we go. Shot is off. That's good. I don't like people hearing me.
High school games? You guys use headsets?
Yeah, we use the headsets, the board, laptop. Well, that's
gotta be a nice experience.
It is.
Makes you feel like a professional.
56-43 is the score. 3:05 remaining in the fourth. And an offensive foul. It's called.
Very hard to find.
Ooh,
in this game.
Tough play. 56-43. Under 3 minutes now in the fourth. Sydney Green has the ball. She dribbles. Sydney Green. Oh, and it's a travel. I don't know why she's complaining.
I think she thought it was called over the back. Or over and back there.
No,
it was a travel. I was just trying to watch the motion she was doing with her foot.
Oh, 56-43 is shooting. And it's going to be a blocking foul on Cayla Thomas. It's a very good crowd here today.
Expecting a good crowd for the men's game as well.
Shot is good. Shot is good.
That's been the difference in this game too, is Cheney's made a lot more of their free throws in center court.
Bub for three. Off. Rebounded by Yoder. Going to go out of bounds off Cheney. Ready for a player of the game. What happened? What did I do? Oh, five fouls.
There's been a lot of fouls called in this game.
On Alicia Jones, number 22. For Central Penn College, I guess we would have to say our player of the game is probably going to be Cayla Thomas, 16 points. Allison Yoder has 11 points, 13 rebounds.
A nice double-double.
Yeah. Cayla Thomas and Allison Yoder with...
Cayla Thomas has taken some hard fouls. I mean, she's played very tough in this game, so I agree with that.
And then for Cheyney... Gianna Robert with 17. Shot is up, and it's good. There must have been a technical foul somewhere, Tyler.
It looks like Sydney Bub coming out to take a couple more free throws.
Bub makes the free throw. 46, 2:18 remaining.
For Penn trying to finish out these last couple minutes of the game strong.
Inside the outer, it's good! 10-point lead for Cheyney. Underneath. Let's see. Gonna be blue ball.
All that talk.
Yeah, I know.
White ball. White ball that way.
You can hear the crowd. Uh-oh. Now they're talking again.
Oh, they're conversing.
It's off blue.
It's all this talk. You gotta overturn the call, right?
White ball. Petro Penn calls back.
There we go.
Gets it to Yoder, and there's a foul. Yoder's first shot at the line is good. Braxton with 12 points tonight. Shot is up. Layoff, rebounded by Sydney Bubb.
Jesse Penn got to push the ball here.
Sydney Bubb with a double-double here tonight. Thomas gets the screen. They kick it to Green. Green dribbles, goes down, throws it up. It's good!
7 points in.
7-point lead for Cheyney.
Only a minute left.
In the corner. Shot is up. Oh, and a foul can be called in Ngakwe.
That's going to be her second personal foul.
Dezir Coleman at the line.
Rebound!
Rebound! She's missing both these free throws.
And she makes the second. A timeout is taken on the floor. Tyler, I think we're going to take one as well. We'll be right back.
Central Penn College Student Government Association is a voice for all students, those living on campus, those studying online, and those returning to continue their education. SGA is here to make your time at Central Penn College the best experience possible. You can contact SGA with any questions, comments, or concerns by emailing sga@centralpenn.edu.
59-51, 103 remaining. Cheney's calling off the press, it looks like. Or they're just making a half-court press, but they're going to double, and they don't. And it's a turnover. No need to rush anything.
Do you think a little late at this point to foul? Maybe they should have tried to foul earlier in the shot clock and they couldn't get the steal?
Yeah.
That's the ball right there. And I sense a little bit of a coach in your mind.
My team's losing currently at the moment. 30-18 at the end of the third. So.
Don't have you there to inspire them right now.
Rebound!
60-51 is the score. Second shot is good.
Maybe in between games here, you can zoom in and get a little pep talk.
61-51, 33 seconds remaining. Two shots at the line. We have an injured player for Cheney. Seconds remaining.
Hey, Central Penn, you'd like to put these free throws and then you can't get a quick steal. You got to foul right away.
Shot is good. We're going to get ready for our men's matchup coming up soon. Is good.
Okay. I gotta try to get a quick steal. No steal and no foul.
Shot clock and game clock line up with each other. And Bob commits the foul.
I'm just confused on that. They ran like 10 seconds off the clock.
That's gonna be 5 on Sidney Bob.
She played well today, Brian. I mean, I believe you said she had a double-double.
She did have a double-double. She did.
Sydney Bum. Take a look here.
10 points, 13 rebounds. So again, 10 points, 13 rebounds.
Tough shows, yeah. Played a good game on senior night. Unfortunately, not going to get the finish she wanted, but still played really well.
She makes the free throw. Christiana Robert again with 18 points. The next one by Christiana Robert is good. 63-53. No need to foul if I'm Cheyney. Shot is off. It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to stay with Central Penn College. 9.9 remaining. So again, the Cheyney University team will be victorious here today.
I think we'll say this all around, Brian, very sloppy game, but Cheyney just turned the ball over a little less.
Shot is off, and it's off. And that's the end of the ball game. 63-53 is the score. In favor of Cheyney, Christiana Robert, 19 points. Natasha Braxton, 14. Jaden Patrick, 9. Maya Bynum, 6. Kayla Johnson, 4. Tamia Finney, 4. Alicia Jones, 4 points. Miranda Carey, 2 points. And then Dizier Coleman, 1 point. For Central Penn College, Cayla Thomas at 19. Allison Yoder, 14 with 13 rebounds. Sydney Buff, the senior, 10 points, 13 rebounds. Sydney Green, 8 points, 5 rebounds. Brandy Swinton, 2 points, 5 rebounds. than Marion Gawkor had a rebound and an assist. So a tough matchup. Tyler, any final words?
Very sloppy game all the way around. You know, it's tough. Didn't want to see this kind of outcome on senior night. You know, you would have liked to see Sydney Bub be sent out on a better note, but you know, I mean, they played well, just made a lot of mistakes, unfortunately. So,
player of the game today. It was 53-63 in favor of Cheyney. The big thing was turnovers. Central Penn had 44, Cheyney had 23. Tyler, that's what we're going to call it. Again, our player of the game today, we had in favor of Cayla Thomas, 19 points today for Central Penn College. Again, our final score, 63-53 in favor of Cheyney. We'll be right back after these messages for the men's contest.